In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a simple design like this one right here. I'm calling it groupings or collections, and you can make it easily in Kittl. I'm going to show you how to do it step by step in Kittl and why I think Kittl is one of the best places to make these kinds of designs. Let's go. Hey everyone, thanks for joining me on this video. My name is Juno with Detour Shirts. In this video, I'm going to show you how to do a simple design, super simple. I'm calling it groupings or collections, either one. We're basically just grabbing different designs, different graphics, and putting them in a group on a t-shirt. Now you may think this is too simple. Does this actually sell? These right here are from Amazon, and these are groupings, and they have sold multiple times a day. Look at those little BSRs. As well as if you go just on Google and search some of these topics, you'll see that they're very popular. So let's go to Kittl. I'll show you exactly how to do it step by step, and I'll show you exactly why I think Kittl is one of the best places to make these designs. So here we are on Kittl, kittl.com. And one of the best reasons why I think Kittl is the best place to do this is because Kittl is known for vintage graphics. And typically what you want to see on these collections, these groupings, are vintage graphics. And those are the ones that are really popular if you've seen the examples and the ones that I showed earlier. So let's start a project and let's look for vintage graphics. And I'll show you why it's not only do they have vintage graphics, but they have groupings already. So let's go to a new project. I'm gonna hit pod presets. I'm gonna do a t-shirt. Now I'm doing a t-shirt and I showed examples of t-shirts, but this could make a great poster as well. So keep that in mind when you're doing it. T-shirt right here, Amazon, you see it's already set. Now, if I go to elements and I go to illustrations, what do we have here? We have groupings already done and we're just looking for some vintage groupings, and they do look vintage flowers. We have, animal heads, that's not as popular. I think fine florals would work, hand-drawn flowers. Now we're looking more for vintage, not vintage graphics, like hand-drawn graphics, but more, you'll see what I mean. Like these kinds of watercolor could work. Let's see. I know we have more vintage stuff here. Vintage vehicles, no. I think this is more towards women. So, oh, vintage insects, perfect. So butterflies. Right, we saw that. Pastel flowers could work. Food, they have vintage food, that could work too. I'll do an example of that. So like I said, they have a ton of illustrations, and you can go down here and just look for some of those vintage graphics that are very popular. Not all of these will work, but I think a lot of these will. So let's go back up, and where's that vintage? I like that butterfly one. So okay, vintage insects. You see there's 51 of them, so you know we have enough. I'm just going to click on them, and I can just start clicking on these and adding them here. So that easy. Boom. And see, this is how easy it is to make it. So if you're not great at putting things around, what I would say is start with a basic 9 square or 3 by 3 square with 9 in them. So let's just pick ones that we like here. Now, the thing about the 9 square is they're all gonna have to be about the same height. And not necessarily width, but height and width, kind of. Okay, so you can see this one's kind of tall and this one's short, so that's not gonna work well for our example of 9 square, so I'm gonna take that one out. And luckily there's so many more designs here. And maybe that one's too small either, so. And we can put some like with the same height here. So if that's the same height as this one, you know, maybe that's better on that line there, and this one's better on this line here. Something like that. All right. So let's say we did that, and then we just make it fit in a 9 square. Boom. Right, we can do that. And some may be bigger, some may be smaller. That's fine. That's actually better if you have some variety of smaller and bigger. So, you know, I can straighten that out, or I could also do something like a tall rectangle. So maybe there's more here. Maybe I wanna bring that other guy back, that tall one, you know, for some color. And now I can play around, like maybe there's some short ones here that will fit underneath like this. Right, as big as that one. Now we're getting variety here. So we're just gonna play around with these. And I know some of these look like moths and some of these look like butterflies, and that's okay. But they all kind of look in the same style. That's what we're looking for. Drawn in the same style, colored in the same style. I'm gonna show you examples of some of these later, but luckily all of these are, if you wanna put in a dragonfly in here, totally fine, right? Gives it variety. Still in this, drawn in the same style, still in that vintage style. And if you wanna book bugs, you could also do one with bugs, right? This is insects. I wouldn't mix, well, you could mix bugs with butterflies if that what you want, but you could also do one just with bugs, I think would be really cool. We're getting into bugs now. So let's see, do we have this orange one? Okay, so I think we got enough in here that I'm just gonna move things around. Maybe another thin one. Do we have another thin one? Oh, this blue one I don't think we used. Right, so we can do something like that. Maybe that one's smaller in here, giving it variety. This one's bigger. And that's it, right? And it's okay if there's white space, totally fine, right? And just make sure you're trying to have like this white edge here and this white edge here and a tall rectangle. Tall rectangle is still what we're looking for. And you can see pretty easily I put that together, right? Now, what's optional is you could put in some text up here. And so luckily, Kittl is really good at fonts, vintage fonts, which match the vintage graphics, right? So I'm gonna hit T here, and I'm gonna, you can see it's right down there. And we can just type in butterflies or whatever, do some research and figure out what you want. In fact, this isn't a butterfly right here, so this may not work, but I'm gonna show you the kind of text that we were looking for. So Roboto, not my favorite for this because we want a vintage text, right? So some of these I found angst is pretty cool, right? You can kind of get away with some script ones too. So because it's more graphic, you don't have to focus on the text. I know a lot of times I say you need to have big bold text for it to read, but in this case, I think it'll be okay if you don't have it. So we could do, you know, some things like this or some things like this, where this one's readable, but I'm saying maybe that. It's harder to read, but that's totally fine because it fits that vintage design, right? There you go, just like that. And then you can export this, go to download and remove background. Make sure 4500 by 5400. You can see it's 300 DPI set already, and hit PNG, boom. Now, I wanna show you some other examples that I've done. You can see I played around with this. I'm gonna go to my profile. That's the one I just did. Look at this one. Just flowers, right? And a different font. Let's go back to my profile. I'll leave this. Watercolor ones. I like this one I did. Think of fruits. Now you can see this is a different style. This is a vintage kind of more hand-drawn with the dark lines, but this is all the same style. And I use this font right here, Adventurer, but I also labeled some of these. So this can be also a great poster as well as a good t-shirt. You can see really nice. Now, typically these will be against a light t-shirt, like a white or a cream or something like that. But I think it still works really well. Let's go see another one. Leave this. This one right here. Fruits. Juicy fruits, right? Now these are all in the same style. They have leaves, right? They're drawn in the same style, just kind of more photorealistic, but still got that vintage feel, right? Okay, one more. I did a lot of these, but I'm not going through all of them. There's that butterfly one that I did, like that one. And let's see, mushrooms. They also have mushrooms, right? And I used like the scientific name on here with this font. It's Fair Prosper. Really cool. So you can do it in so many ways. Again, go down, go into elements, and this is why Kittl is awesome, is they already have the groupings, right? So they have one with the fruits, and they have one with the mushrooms, and they have one with the different things that I showed here. So have fun, get creative with this. I think this is a really cool design style that you can do pretty easy without a Kittl template. I'll put some of these templates on there just so you can have them, but you don't need a Kittl template. You can literally go on there and just pick 9 to 12 different graphics that are all the same style and just put it on the t-shirt and maybe some words, maybe not. This will do fine without words, right? If I took this off and deleted it, that's fine too. This is a fine design. So have fun with this again, get creative, and hopefully make some sales. Well, there you go, super simple design style, grouping or collections, whatever you wanna call it. Use those vintage graphics that Kittl has. They just make it super easy, as well as with the fonts. I think that font pairing, the vintage font and the vintage graphics go really well together, and it can help you sell these. Again, no guarantees, but you can see this is very popular right now, especially on lighter t-shirts and on posters. So if you want to put them on a poster, I think this would be great too. So have fun with these. If you want to see more Kittl designs, I have a whole playlist right here for Kittl. Lots of different styles. You can go on there, use some templates, and get some really cool designs on there too. Thanks again for watching. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.